Good afternoon. I am discussing the topic language teaching skills. As we know, language is regarded as the most communication and education. Education is not achieved through the study of a language or two. It is a lifelong process and includes the entire spectrum of languages taught in an educational institution. Languages are essentially skill-based subjects rather than knowledge-based. Therefore, all languages should be taught and evaluated based on skills. Generally, all languages have four basic skills: listening, speaking, reading, and writing. First, the learner hears a new item, like a sound, word, grammar, features, etc. Then he tries to repeat the new item. Next, he sees the new item in written form. And finally, the learner reproduces the written form of the item. Listening and reading are known as receptive skills because we receive language components through these skills, while speaking and writing are known as productive skills because we produce a language meaningfully through these. Now, we will discuss the four skills and the procedures for developing each of them among the learners. Skill of listening. Listening is a great way to develop vocabulary and comprehension. It is important to make the listening active rather than passively engrossing the content. When we listen, we pay conscious attention to what is said. If a teacher develops the listening skill in the students, the rest three skills will grow automatically. Now the procedures for developing listening skill. Reproduction exercises. The teacher produces a sound, word, or a sentence and asks the students to reproduce the same in group and then individually. Asking questions. The teacher will narrate a story or any information to the learners and asks questions. The students will answer them after listening carefully. Performing actions. The teacher performs actions with speech and the students are then asked to do the same accordingly. By giving dictation, the teacher will dictate and the students will be asked to write accordingly to enhance their skill of listening as well as writing. Prediction exercises. The teacher tells a part of a story and then asks the students to complete the rest. Their power of listening and thinking may be enhanced through such exercises. Then the skill of speaking. Developing speaking skill involves gaining fluency in spoken interactions with others. It is the basic skill of language for communication. Listening may not lead eventually to speaking unless listening is followed by practice at the grammatical as well as lexical levels. In actual speaking situations, most of the components operate simultaneously. It is expected to make these functions as automatic habits through practice. There are three important areas of spoken language. They are mechanics, function, social and cultural norms. The mechanics of spoken language is the use of right words in the right grammatical order with acceptable pronunciation. And spoken language generally has two functions, interaction and transmission. Interaction means expression of thoughts, ideas, experiences, opinions, passing on information. And the transmission is concerned only with conveying a message or factual information. Social and cultural norms correspond to the sense of time, place, and action while anything being spoken. Now the procedure for developing speaking skill. Rehearsing dialogues. Dialogues on simple, contextualized situation should be tried within a group or between a pair of the students as applicable. This will provide enough opportunities to practice speaking skill. Fluency versus accuracy. The students should be provided many opportunities to speak within and even outside the classroom. It is not worth bothering whether the students are uttering grammatically correct sentences or not. Fluency should be desired at first. Once fluency is achieved, accuracy will automatically appear in due course. Reading pictures. For the beginners, read on pictures is an important task for enhancing speaking skill. Using set of spoken exchanges, the teacher will provide sets of spoken exchanges like greetings, invitations, interaction, and ask the students to use those sets in conversations within or between groups. Interviewing. The teacher will interrogate the students to promote readiness among the students while speaking. This activity will lead them to get rid of fear and anxiety while speaking. Skill of reading. Reading is a procedure of observing at a written document and translating it into apposite sound. In fact, it is the ability which enables the pupils to extract from the printed text the thoughts, facts, and information that the text provides. The procedures to develop reading skills are eco-reading. The teacher gives a model reading before the class, and the pace, stress, annotation remain echoed to the learners. Then the students are asked to read the same passage accordingly. Duet reading. The teacher and the student will read at a time. The student will try to go at par with the teacher in every aspect of reading. The teacher may sometimes pause and repeat if the student finds something difficult. Quran reading. All the students read together, and sound produced by the chorus helps one another to read with fluency, accuracy, and with a reasonable speed. This is very much common and frequently found in our classroom. Group dynamic reading. Here the students are divided into some groups. The group member follow one another attentively while reading and help in problem situations. Use of tasks and activities. The teacher will assign the students with simple tasks like cause-effect relationship, arranging jumble sentences to make sure about the effectiveness of reading procedure of the learners. Finally, the skill of writing. Writing is a skill by which we produce a sequence of meaningful sentences. Writing is a slower process than speaking, and the learners need much time to search for new words and make meaningful sentences. He is not worried about the pronunciation, phrase, and annotation patterns. However, the word order and the spelling are the important factors while writing. The procedures for developing writing skill. Problem solving task. The teacher will present a story or a situation partially and then ask the students to complete those. He will provide the learners with some hints or questions. Questions like, give me a suitable end to this story, or if you were in this situation, what would you do? Writing of authentic text. The learners will be asked to write something based on real life situations, such as notes, letters, postcards, telegram, etc. Guided writing. The students will write on their own after brainstorming ideas. Write about a happy memory, domestic animals, and so on. Free writing. The students will write about the free topics such as culture, history, sports, etc. Dicto composition. The teacher here first dictates a passage or a story and asks the students to write. Closed passages. The teacher provides a fragmented passage and then asks the students to complete it. Teachers are the facilitators and responsible of creating the best possible environment for writing. The activity should be linked to the real life as much as possible. From the above discussion, we can say all language learners need to develop their competences in each of these four skills, and language classes should incorporate activities related to these skills. And these four capabilities allow an individual to comprehend, produce, and use the language in effective interpersonal communication. Thank you.
Actually, Devjani, you have taken too many things there.
Yes, sir.
You should have taken at least just one of them. That's why a lot of things could not be clarified. I'll just talk of this, your reading skills. Reading skills, what has happened is, you have the procedure part. You're only talking of the loud reading. You're not talking of the silent reading, which is more important. This is not that important, really. So you should have emphasized on silent reading and then should have talked of the skills, how to develop speed reading, how to skim, how to scan, and all these, those things should have come. So similarly, in writing, there are a lot of other steps required, which were not discussed. So listening and speaking, I'm not talking at the moment. There are vast areas, a lot of things could have done. At least next time onwards, whenever you get a chance, don't take so many things, just take one. Even when you go to the classroom during practice teaching or once you go to the real classroom, just concentrate on one thing. And there also, like, there will be a lot of other components.
Yes, so
it need not be extensive, make it intensive. That is more important. That way, like, students will learn. Yeah, otherwise good. Yes.
Okay, sir.
Shankar, you tried to say something?
No, as you said, focus should be on one aspect of teaching. One skill should be taken up at a time. That's right. Because otherwise, too many things have to be said, which may make the presentation a bit lengthy.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Anyone else? Any comment?